So, construction details. So yesterday we did design details. Today's construction details. Tomorrow we'll do care instructions, which is fun and easy. But for the construction details, we're going to learn, we're going to talk about the construction details page in depth. And then at the end, we're going to go to the control panel and set up some construction detail templates and add those details to the style. So let's go ahead and log in to the UniquePLM, and you can log in on your own instance or you can log in the training instance. Either one is fine. So I'm going to go ahead and log in and go to a style. I'm going to just open the style, one of the styles that I was working on. I'm not sure if it's the same one I was working on yesterday or not. Let me just open one up and see what I have. So yesterday we were doing the design details, which had some, you know, information on, this looked like stitching instructions and thread placement. The construction details page is similar to the design details page in a sense of that we are going to add a listing of instructions. And when you're in your style and you click on the construction details link in the left-hand navigation, the first thing we want to do is click new, because we're going to add a new page to this style. The construction details is often used for a variety of instructional information. So construction, which is like assembly instructions, right? And then click add. And now you can see I have one construction details page. It's called assembly instructions, also known as construction details. I'm going to add another one of those pages. So I'm going to click on construction details where it says construction details one. So the main workflow. And then I'm going to click new again, and I'm going to add another one. Because maybe I need to describe. So the first one I did, how to assemble. Maybe I need to describe label placement. Or labeling instructions. I'm going to do a few of these. And then I'm going to add another one. And maybe this is going to be, I'm going to call it new. And maybe this one is going to be pressing instructions. So how to press this. And then I think I might do a couple more. I'm going to do another one, and I'm going to do new, and I'm going to say folding instructions. So how to fold this thing. I'm going to do another one, and I'm going to say new. This time I'm going to say packing instructions.
Okay.
So how to pack it, to put it in a poly bag, put six in a specific size box in this way. Right. So now I have five different construction details pages in this one style, and they're all going to talk about different instructions, how to do different things. And just for fun, I'm going to start on the assembly instructions page. So in my assembly instructions page, I'm going to click on edit, and then it's going to open up this page. And we can add rows to this page so that if in case we don't have anything built in the control panel yet, we can just add a number of rows to this page, and we can just start typing how to put this thing together. The first column is little checkboxes, and that allows you to select and then remove a row. Then there is a column here that has a little blue up arrow. That's for you to upload an image for this row. And then there's a sort order. And then there's a class, subclass, feature, and detail, and then a bunch of user-defined fields. These user-defined headers can be translated in administration. This class, subclass, and features is just a hierarchy, right, of organizing your details. So class could be the product type that you are working on. I'm going to say this is a dress. This is for dresses. And my subclass is, okay, maybe what kind of dress or what part of the dress are we going to talk about? I'm going to talk about the seams, the side seams. I'm just going to say seams. And then my feature is going to be, okay, which seam are we going to talk about? I'm going to say side seams. And then my detail would be, okay, how are we sewing our side seams together on the dress? I'm going to say 1 inch, however you describe talking about your seams. 1 inch seam allowance using single needle, blah, blah, blah. And then depending on whatever you use for your user-defined fields, again, it could be the stitch per inch. You could say, okay, 8 stitches per inch, 8 SPI, and then whatever thread type, you can say whatever coats, 60, whatever, blah, 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 okay? And I can just keep doing that. So I'm going to go down to the next row, and I'm going to say dress, seams, and I'm going to say shoulder seams. And then this, whatever, half inch, SA, using whatever, needle. You get the idea, right?
Okay.
And I'm going to save. So that's one way of entering information into this. And then you would just keep going until you finish describing how to put this thing together, how you're going to do your hems, pocket information, whatever, everything. And then you could upload an image of each step. So if you wanted to put in an image of what this 1 inch single needle seam would look like, you could upload an image of that. It could be a photograph or a sketch. Another way to get information in here is just to pull information from the library. If you have information set up in the control panel, then you can pull it from that library. And this is broken down by category, class, and subclass. On your system, you're going to define what these are, what the classes are, and the subclasses, and then you're going to build your features and your details. Okay. For this example, my classes, you can see I've got dress construction is one class, jacket construction, sweater, da-da-da, okay? And then the subclasses that are set up is assembly, and it could have been seams, it could have been whatever, and then my features. So I can select these construction detail and link it to my page, okay? Another way, I'm going to go ahead and save this and then talk about another hierarchy, if you will, for this. So I started with saying that my class is the dress, and my subclass are the seams, and my feature is the location of the seam. Another way to think about your hierarchy is you may change that, and you may say my class is assembly, my subclass is dress, and my feature is the side seams. So you can kind of do this however makes sense to you. All right, so that's how to use the page. I'm going to go ahead and close this page and then go to my home. So I'm going to click on the PLM main tab at the top in my browser, and then I'm going to click on home to get to the home screen for PLM. And then here I can go to the control panel. And in the control panel, where we're going to go is the templates area. And we're going to go to the construction details. The way to start building out your system is to just start with the category. So I just clicked on the word category here, and I now have the ability to add a class to this category. I can rename this category, by the way, and I can have multiple categories. So let's go ahead and add a class to this category. And the way that we're going to do that is just click on this Add Class button in the right-hand side. Add Class. And then give it a name. I'm going to say CBS Dress. And then Save as New. So now I have a new class underneath category, CBS Dress. And now I can add the subclass. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Add Subclass, and it'll add to the CBS Dress class. And I'm going to say Seam Details, whatever, however you want to call it, and Save as New. And then we can, from here, add new features to that subclass. My subclass is Seam Details, and my new feature is going to be, what seam are we talking about? This can be side seam. You could be more specific. You could say what kind of seam you want to talk about. So you could say French side seam, right? And then describe how you do a French side seam together, blah, blah, blah. Okay. And then you can attach a file, an image of what this is supposed to look like. It can be a photograph or it can be a sketch. And then just click Add. And then you can just keep adding features to this subclass so that you're going to get a long listing of how to sew this dress together with the seam details. I'm going to go ahead and just save this. And I'm going to tree open my CBS dress construction details in the middle area so I can see there's my CBS dress stuff. I only have seam details, but if you look through the other stuff that's already been created, like under jacket construction, you can see they've got fusing as a subclass, and then you can see that there's destructions. There's instructions on how to fuse, where to put fusing in the different locations. There's labeling, the label placement information, like how to put a label on. The lining instructions, then the packaging, and pressing, etc. Okay. And the purpose, again, the purpose of having this in here is so that you don't have to retype it every style, because your style, you're gonna, there's only so many ways to sew a garment, right? Or to put something together. And so it's nice to just build it into a template and then just copy and paste it into your style. Okay. So go ahead and add some subclasses for your product type. So I've got seam details. To add another subclass to your product type, once you've added some features, and if you want to go back and add another subcategory here, so I've got CBS dress. Let's say now I want to add fusing as another level, I just click on CBS Dress and then click on Subclass. Click on Add Subclass and it will then let me add another subclass. So I'm going to say Fusing and Save a New. And then I can start adding features to that new subclass. All right. Any questions so far? So what this reminds me of is when you're looking at a recipe card, you know how on a recipe card, you at the top, you have the list of ingredients and how many the ingredients. Yeah. I think of the recipe card, the ingredients list is your bill of materials. And then the down below, it has the directions of how to, you know, how to mix these pieces together, mix for 2 minutes until butter is soft, whatever. That's what this is. These construction details, those are the directions for how to bake a cake, right? Yeah. I don't know if anybody cooks anymore, so maybe I should stop using that example.
Yeah, no, but that's definitely a good analogy. And you have to put it in the correct order.
You do, absolutely. And that's the other thing, is that when you have all of these details in here, all of these features, when you bring them into your page, you're going to be able to sort them in any order, right? You can sort them however you want. Uh-huh. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go back to my style. I'm going to say, okay, I love my details. They look great. I'm going to go into my style now. I'm going to go back into my style, and in my page, I'm going to go ahead and edit my page, and I'm going to go to the CD library, the construction details library, and select my new construction details. I'm going to search by class, categories, search by class, CBS dress. And I don't think I built that many features, but let me go to jacket because there's a bunch there. I can grab the ones I want. Da, 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 da. I want that one. I want this one. I want this one. I want this one. And link it to your page. Then you can put them in any order that you want. Okay. And I'm going to save. So that's cool. And that's basically it. That's your construction details page. When you print the page, so I'm going to click on preview. And when you print it, there's several different layouts available. I'm going to do this 1x3 just for fun, and then preview. And you can kind of see what one of the printouts look like. And so it's much more kind of just listed out. And this is the layout I use the most. Yep. Just okay, because.
Cool. Oh, no,
so let's see. What were we supposed to do today? Uh-huh. Yes. Your stuff is really ornate. It's very special. For your assignment, if you would like to, on your own system, you might want to go ahead and start building out your construction details control panel area, just to kind of get the feel for it, or not. It's your choice. If you want to, go ahead and add two construction details pages to your style in the training system. You can link and unlink and copy and remove and sort your details, add images to your page, set up some details in the control panel. And you can delete the pages from a style. Let me show you that. I've got five construction details pages on this style. Let's say I don't need all five of these. If I click on the construction details main node here, then I can remove the pages that I don't need. So I can go ahead and remove the packing and the folding and the da 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 da. I can remove all of those just by selecting them and clicking remove. Okay. And yes, you can copy construction details pages from one style to another by just selecting the style you want to copy from and select the pages you want to copy. I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. So in the page, when I'm editing this page, when I bring details in from the control panel, so like in this case, I have brought in a bunch of jacket construction details in from the control panel, from the CD library. If I want to change any of this information, I cannot edit this until I break the link. So you're going to select the row that you want to edit and then click break link. And now I can then change any of this information. So I can go ahead and change and then change this. Okay. Does that make sense? And then save.
Mm-hmm.
And anywhere you see these little blue up arrows, that tells me that I can upload an image here. And then the little picture with the red X, that's a delete image icon. And then there's this green arrow button. That's a relink button. So if I want to relink it back to the control panel, I just edited it. If I want to bring it back to the original from the control panel, I can just click on relink and it will relink it back to the control panel and revert all of the changes that I made to that one item. Okay. And I think that's everything. And you'll notice if you hover your mouse or your pointer over any of these little icons, it kind of gives you a tooltip and tells you what it's doing. So if I hover over the chain link, it says this item is linked to a template. And then, you know, again, for my images, if I hover over the images, it says click for larger view. If I hover over the X by the image, it says delete image. So it's kind of intuitive or at least helpful with the little tool tips. Alrighty. So I think that covers it. So now you should be able to go to create your construction details in your style and add and remove and sort your details and images and add details from your library and set up your details in the control panel. Do you have any questions about what we covered today? Tomorrow, what are we doing tomorrow? So come in tomorrow and we'll do the measurement templates. We'll talk about how to build those templates out in the control panel and use them in your measurement page. Okay.
Okay.
Awesome. Thanks for joining today.
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.